have some outlets, yeah? Have some outlets that are going to be good and healthy for you. Do you know what I mean? For me, growing up, because I liked the creative writing, I could literally take myself away and write something, you know? And yeah, I'd have delight within that. And to be honest with you, sometimes I wouldn't complete like a whole poem or I don't know, a play or something like that. I wouldn't complete it in one go sometimes, but when I've done what I needed to do for that particular day, I feel like there's been a sense of achievement and I've breathed. I don't feel as bad as I was feeling. You know what I mean? If that makes sense.
But I think that also goes to your interest. And sometimes the things as us that we're interested in, to maybe your surrounding, like, no, I'm not going to make anybody know that because they might think I'm a little bit softer and this, that, and the other. It's not about other people. What makes you feel a level of release? Tap into that. You know, I was saying that to my girls the other day, that in recent times I've taken a liking to jazz music.
Yes.
And my
friend was like, yes.
Really? I don't know this side of you, it's called growth. And the peace that I feel, it's just a different level. You know, so you find your outlet. Or sometimes I like to go to the steam room, the spa room, and I'll be there for 2 days.
Oh, glory. Yes.
But that's my way just to relax,
shut off, and rejuvenate
myself again.
But everyone's
way is different. And as I said, it's about us celebrating each other.
Your way is different, but I respect that.
But my way is different. Let's respect each other's way of de-stressing. Renewing ourselves.
As
long as the person or individual who's going through the situation, they're able to keep continuing to go through their process, let them have their way. As long as if they're not just deteriorating or being destructive, that's when we should be like, come on, what are you doing?
Definitely. You know what's deep? I had a few other outlets. Like, I used to train a lot. So when I used to train, well, I didn't, a lot of the time I didn't train off my own back. When I was a lot younger, I used to train off my own back. But when I got older, it was one of my cousins. He used to ring my phone all my days. And then if he didn't call me, I wouldn't be doing no exercise. I would just be, But he, you know, made me exercise. And that was something that was really good, because especially when I was going through a lot of like things that were hard to endure, the training helped, because it helped your mental capacity.
Yes, definitely.
Because you start pushing some boundaries that, you know, you didn't expect. Do you know what I mean? So it might be that, you know, last week you can do this, but then this week you can now do this. Do you know what I mean? And it gives you that encouragement. Do you know what I mean? To try things in your personal life, because there might be something that you try and fail, but because you've got a conquering kind of mindset, you know, a triumphant kind of mindset because of the exercise, for example, then you're like, yeah, let's go. Or perhaps if you're some people like me, I love cycling. From when I was a child, me and I didn't play football and all that, basketball, just bikes. Me and the bikes. Had so many bikes. I've had bike accidents. But you see, when I had a mad bike accident, I'm back on the bike. Do you know what I mean? I've never let it discourage me. You know what I mean? No matter how mash up I've been, I'm back on the bike. And it's deep, because cycling for me taught me a lot about endurance. Like keeping, you know what I mean? Just keep going. It's like, but I'm tired. No, but keep going. You know what I mean? I want to give up. No, you know, keep going. Do you know what I mean? Like, we have to continue, because I'm not at my destination yet. Do you know what I mean? When I used to work in the city, I used to cycle, and people, you ride all the way there. I'm like, yeah, it don't take long. How long does it take you? Like, an hour? I'm like, no. Like, 20 minutes. They're like, what? But it didn't take me 20 minutes at first. It took me about 35 minutes at first. Then it became 30 minutes. Then it became 25 minutes. Then it became like 20 minutes, 25 minutes. You know what I mean?
The process.
And even though I know that it might take me like 20 minutes, or 25 minutes sometimes, there's times that I'm halfway there and I'm tired. tired. I've just got started and I'm tired, you know. But then I'm like, nope, we've got a long way to go. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? We've got a long way to go. So I just have to keep going, keep going. And that was something that was, again, training my mind again. You know what I mean? So these different outlets that we have are blessings. You know what I mean? They're really, really good. They're really, really good. And like,
even just going to walking in the park.
That's what I was going to get to next.
Just walking.
Mm-hmm. Just walking. Yeah, you'd be surprised how you just, how your brain just, you know what I mean, has that clarity and stuff like that. And that's another thing what I used to love with the dogs, because I still do, is that you can walk your dog and not see anyone because you're walking somewhere where you're not going to see anyone. Or you can walk your dog where other people are walking their dogs and you get talking and it becomes a social thing. Mm. So that would be another thing. I just decide like how I'm feeling on the day. Do I want to see people? You know what I mean? And then I would decide. But again, it taught me so much about like how good it is to just speak to new people. Do you know what I mean? I'd walk my dog sometimes and people start telling me their whole life. Do you know what I mean?
But that just shows you that when somebody comes up to you, because sometimes you're like, oh my gosh, why did they tell me so much?
Yeah.
But at that moment, that individual just needed to talk. And because of the society we live in now, we're always busy. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, and it's not like we don't want to speak with each other, be like, but because of how our lives are so busy.
Yeah.
So you can meet someone and be like, oh, small talk, then do you know what? It all comes out.
Yeah.
Because they've been holding up for so long.
Yeah. It's deep.
And it's important. I just believe it's important to express yourself,
express
your feelings, but in an environment where you can feel safe.
Yes, definitely.
That no one's going to laugh at you if you feel deflated today, or I feel hurt today, or I feel, you know?
Definitely.
It's okay, because once you can accept and acknowledge how you're feeling, then that's allowing you to release that feeling.
Definitely.
To be able to go forward.
Definitely, definitely.
To
definitely
overcome that.
Definitely, definitely. You know what? I was gonna ask Marie as well, is because I'm asking you because you've already done it, yeah.
Okay.
This is for the fabulous listeners. This is for the great listeners. This is for the beautiful listeners. This is for the strong listeners. This is for the listeners who are not feeling so strong today. Yeah.
For everyone.
This is for everybody. Yeah. For everybody. Yeah. What would you say to someone out there who knows someone who has got a great potential, but they know that that person is not fulfilling their potential?
Continue to encourage them. Mm. Do not give up on them. Mm. Even if it means that you say to that person, I've got you. I'm going to continue to check in on you and see how you get on. Because we have to be mindful that when someone is going through something, we have to give them space at the same time.
Yeah.
They're still trying to work things out.
That's right.
But we're being accountable to them. So I will check in on you. And if I see that you're displaying, keyword, behaviors, I will put you into check. Out of love.
Out of love.
Out of love, because I want the best for you.
Yeah.
I can see that you've got potential. I can see you've got a gift. I can see you've got a purpose.
Yeah. That's
I can
right.
see you've got a calling.
That's right.
And I feel that it's my responsibility can see that to encourage you. Because if I'm going forward, trust me, you're coming with me.
Coming with.
Because you have a purpose that needs to be fulfilled.
That's right.
So just continue to encourage. Encourage and support. Check in on each other. We need to do that more.
We need to do that more. We need to do that more. Everyone's so busy nowadays. People ain't got time to check in on people again.
Yeah, even if you send, you know, because of technology moving forward, send a WhatsApp. Hi, how are you? Are you okay? You know, sometimes you might not always get a chance to make a phone call.
Yeah.
Just tap in.
Just
are
a quick one. Definitely.
Yeah,
I think that's
also,
what we
need even to though
do.
Our lives are so busy, and it's something I'm also learning as well, we still, if somebody phones you, as long as it's convenient and they need to talk, let's make that time.
Yes.
Even
if
it's 5 minutes.
Even
let's
5 minutes. You can get a lot done in 5 minutes. Yeah. Like, you can get a lot done
I
in 5 minutes.
I know we all are busy. I'm not disregarding that, but sometimes that person can call, and you never know, that one conversation for 2 minutes.
Come on.
Can make a difference.
How long was the word of encouragement about identity that you sent to Norman? How long was that? Like,
I was getting ready to go to work, and I just said it was just a voice note.
A voice note.
He was like, it wasn't even a minute, it was like a couple of seconds.
Yeah.
And then I said, he was like,
that was really powerful.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah, yeah,
normally
yeah,
it's Cockney voice.
Yeah.
And I said, what did I say?
Yeah. Yeah.
So when I listened to it, I thought, okay. Mm-hmm. But that was only a couple of seconds.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the process of getting myself ready for work and my daughter ready for school. It was just a couple of seconds.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes, you know, just to even, as you know, technology doing really well, you just send someone a voicemail. Good morning. I'm wishing you a blessed day. I used to send my friends and myself, I used to send them quotes. You're amazing. If you could see yourself through my eyes.
This is what
I can
I'm
see
saying. You all
a
need
there,
a Marie in your life.
Hundred percent.
Oh, big up Marie, man. Serious. Big up
even
Marie.
Even if you, as an individual, couldn't see it.
Yes.
For some reason, something I could see. So I'm encouraging you. You know, you're amazing.
Yeah.
You've got purpose. If you can see what I could see, you would fix up quick. You know, in love. But
in
love.
Let's
encourage one another.
Yeah, definitely.
Let's
definitely
build up our village now instead of killing. Like, I want to be honest. When I was younger. You know, I used to kill people with my words before I had more knowledge about how powerful my words were.
There's power in
and
the tongue,
said,
man.
No, I'm choosing to encourage,
edify
speak
life.
People, speak life.
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 Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I say to my kids, you can.
Mm-hmm.
So do you know whose child you are?
Oh, glory.
I said, don't be silly.
Come
you're my
on.
Child.
You're
don't
my child.
Silly.
Yeah, yeah,
don't
yeah, yeah,
silly.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
You know?
Facts, facts, facts.
I just speak life to myself to keep encouraging them. You can do this.
Yeah.
You know, if they choose they want to go a particular path or career that I don't have a career for my children, say, so I want you to do da 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 da. As long as they're doing something that is the right way and they're enjoying it, you've got my 100% support.
Yeah.
If they want to start a business,
yeah,
I will help them.
Yeah.
As long as they've got the right concept and they have to endure.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they can, like my daughter says, she wants to be a dancer.
Mm-hmm.
She says she wants to be a chef.
Mm-hmm.
She wants to be a policewoman.
Mm-hmm.
She says she wants to be a doctor. I said to her, Special K, you can do it all.
Mm-hmm.
Choose what day you want to be what and just do it.
That's right.
Because you can.
Right.
Why
that's
not?
Right.
Why can't
that's
you
right.
do it? Mm-hmm. Why?
You know what's funny? This big up Anton, you know. Anton, you know, he's helping us, you know, with our first show, you know. Like, big up Anton. This instrumental, the tune is called Quiet Storm. And it's deep because a lot of people are out there going through
very quiet storm.
Quiet storm. You can't even recognize. I was going through a quiet storm when Marie met me, definitely. Do you know what I mean? And, you know, we can hear on the hook there where the rapper said, this is the real hip hop, yeah? But when he's saying it in his way. He just means it's the real. Like, the real hip hop, yeah? That is what he's saying, yeah? It's the real hip hop, yeah? Because it's the real hip hop, yeah? Whatever you're going through is the real hip hop, yeah? But we're gonna help you get through the hip hop, yeah? We're gonna help you hit through the hop.
Everybody's story is different.
I understand. Everyone's got a unique
different.
One.
Yeah.
And what I want to even, like, echo as well is Marie said, don't give up on them. Yeah? Don't give up on them. And we are emphasizing that we are not giving up on anyone.
Nope.
Yeah? We are not giving up on anyone.
But we appreciate that at times you need a bit of space. And I will respect that.
Yes.
If you say today, I just don't feel like it. Okay, I respect that.
Yep.
But I'm still here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
that's
still
it.
Here.
That's it.
When you're ready, I'm here.
That's it.
It's about boundaries as well. You have to respect people's boundaries.
But that's the thing. If people's over, but listen, all right. You see the fact that I haven't been doing like some of the activities that I was doing for a long time, like the shows in the theatres and stuff like that. hundreds of people. It weren't that I had loads of people onto me like every day, for example, but there were loads of people onto me every day, if that makes sense. So what I mean by that is it wasn't always the same person, like on my case, but it was different people, and it was just like, oh my gosh, there's no way I can like avoid this. Like, do you know what I mean? There's nothing I can do to avoid this. And that was so encouraging. It has been encouraging. So anyone out there who's personally been on my case, anyone who's been asking me when's the next show, anyone who's been out there asking me what are you up to, I appreciate you. and I've got nothing but love for you, because it's a caring thing to do. Do you know what I mean? There's people who genuinely have not given up on me, yeah? And you never know, it might be that day where you have an impression, like, message Jordan today. Like, ask him how he is. Ask him how's the poetry. That message there might be the one that make me do the mad thing. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it's the same with Marie. Do you know what I mean? But we're here, like, to put that out. Do you know what I mean? Sometimes we're going to have guests come in and join us and stuff like that. When the guests come in, the guests will start explaining their stories and stuff like that. And it's going to be more deeper encouragement. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. But what I have identified in Marie is that she's got, like, a very calm, soothing voice, but there's so much authority with the voice. Do you know what I mean? So she's saying, she told us she's a teacher, yeah? So
I didn't tell you that one.
Oh, you didn't?
No, I didn't.
You did tell the people you're a teacher?
No, I was keeping that little secret.
Oh my gosh. All right. Cool. we're going to get into that stuff even more. But before I jump back off and give Marie the mic again, yeah? It's that the ability... some people have the ability to literally resurrect the dead with their words, yeah? Like, a person out there might be feeling that their gifting is dead. A person might be feeling out there like their talent is dead. Oh, that was back then. Oh, that was then. Things were different then, for example. Do you know what I mean? But you can still upskill and get back into it, for example. Do you know what I mean? Like, there might be a lady out there or a gent out there who loves baking or loves cooking, for example. Yeah, but look how many foods businesses there are. Look how many, like, girls are doing cakes now, for argument's sake. Yeah, but you're doing cakes.
But yours is unique.
Oh, come on.
Yours is unique.
It doesn't matter, like, how saturated the market is, or this, that, or the other.
You have to put your unique twist
on. Oh, come on. Come on. And you don't know when something great is going to happen. Do you know what I mean? And for anyone out there who is feeling like their gifting is dead, you know,
it isn't.
Yeah. It isn't. And that's
your
what we're here to tell
dead
you.
When you are dead,
basically.
You're no longer on this earth.
Basically.
So
where
as long
there's
as
life,
alive,
there's hope. Mm-hmm.
Every day you wake up and your eyes are open,
come on.
Resurrect your gift.
Come on.
Because I don't want to come looking for you guys.
Because she will. and she will find you.
Let you know.
Yeah, I wake up
very early as well.
Oh, yeah. With the joy. That's what I'm saying. It's soothing. And it is, like, such a tough love that comes with it. Like, that's how, listen, when Marie was onto me, yeah, I was like, oh. But I wanted to see Marie because, like, that joy and that vibrant, you know, nature, like, it's encouraging. Do you know what I mean? Like, you feel appreciated, like, just when she says hello. Do you know what I mean? Because God's given her that gift to be a blessing to people just by, like, saying hello. Do you know what I mean? And Marie didn't know how many seeds she was sowing, like, when she was speaking to me. Marie didn't know how many times she was watering the seeds that were sown. Do you know what I mean? It could be something that someone else has said, and Marie's come and watered it. For example, Marie could have said something to me, sowed a seed, and another person's watered it. Do you know what I mean? By the grace of God. So you can't give up on people, yeah? You know what? I was trying to... one of my uncles in Jamaica the other day, the guy can't say people, you know. He says people. Yeah? Oh, that's what he said.
I just think Jamaicans are all comedians. I love them.
Listen, yeah. Listen, I think Jamaicans are solar panels. Yeah? I think they get all the energy from the sun, yeah? And that is it. They turn that into energy, yeah? So when people, yeah? And I'm just like, the guy is different, you know. Big him up. But you don't know, like, how the word that you give to a person is going to shape that person's identity. Do you know what I mean? Let's start speaking life. Let's start encouraging people. Do you know what I mean? So that is what Evening Talks is going to be about encouraging people. And you know, it feels like we spoke a lot today, but we had to let the people know where we're coming from. Do you know what I mean? Not just getting into it and, you know, for the sake of it, but we want to let people know that there's layers to us, there's layers to what we've been through, there's layers and intricacy to the giftings that God has given unto us. Do you know
but
what I mean?
The key thing is that I can say, and I can also witness with Georgian as well, in the midst of, because we've all gone through things,
mm-hmm.
we all, but we never gave up.
Come on.
And what happened, what was meant to break you, empowered us.
Come on.
And no matter what you go through, do not allow you, yes, you will fall low. It mm-hmm. will make you feel a bit broken.
Mm-hmm.
Do not allow it to break you.
Mm-hmm.
It's about it building you.
Come on. Come on.
Bringing you up.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's what it's meant to do.
Mm-hmm.
Not break you,
mm-hmm.
rebuild you,
mm-hmm.
strengthen you,
mm-hmm.
for you to go forward.
Come
what
on.
You need to be doing. Your purpose.
Your purpose.
Your handprint.
Come on.
Let's
come
print
on.
Out here.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on. Come on. this tune here that we're about to play is a very, very, very special tune. It means a lot to Marie. It means
yes,
a lot to
does.
Me as well. Like, it's a very, very, very big tune. Let this tune minister to you. Let this tune uplift you right now. It's Jonathan McReynolds.
Can't. I'm not good
yeah,
with song
lyrics. Yeah, cannot tell it all. So yeah, we're gonna spin this tune for you right now on Just Cool Radio. Yeah. Big up my nephew, you know what I mean? But yeah, we've had a great, great, great show. And on the theme of identity, as we're coming to a conclusion here, you know, we want to emphasize about identity, because there's so much to it. Like, I don't think that we even scratched the surface today. We said a lot, but we ain't scratched the surface. Like, to really go deep into identity, we have to make it a theme. Like, you know what I mean? Who knows? I don't know. We'll confer. We'll have a debrief. We'll confer.
We're going to the office tomorrow and we will go over our notes.
That's right. That's right. But on the theme of identity, what I want to leave with you is, for those of you who are out there and you feel you're in between, like, two conflicting opinions, for argument's sake, you're somewhat, you know, this person and you're somewhat that person, but you're not quite sure, you're still working it out, I want to say to everyone, be yourself. Be honest with yourself, because at the end of the day, the only people who know the truth is you and God. You know what I mean? The only people who know the truth is you and God. You know what I mean? And I believe that when we walk in our true self, we walk in our true destiny, yeah, and we invest time within ourselves, invest time in ourselves and spend time with yourself,
yes,
developing
definitely.
Yourself, impacting yourself, yeah, allowing yourself to be impacted, speaking life to yourself,
definitely.
Yeah, we want to make that a habit, so that
look into the mirror.
Oh, come
say,
on,
oh, I love you.
Yeah,
you can do this.
Yeah.
I've got
come
you.
On, come on, yeah? Come on, come
look
on.
Look at your features and
come
say,
on,
yeah.
Come on.
My nose is different. My lips are different.
Oh,
my
yeah,
eyes are
yeah,
different.
Yeah,
my ears
yeah.
are different. My hair is
yeah,
fabulous.
Yeah.
Encourage
yeah.
you.
Yes.
And it's okay at times to be by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And but in the midst of being by yourself, renew your mind.
Renew your mind.
Feed your mind and your spirit with positivity.
That's right.
Positive people.
That's
positive
right. That's right. You'll be very surprised. The more you develop your relationship with yourself, you know, and going through that process, you know, I believe you will find your identity, like, in greater capacities than you can imagine, you know. So walk in it. Be bold. Yeah.
And rediscover your identity. Mm. Now you're equipped to walk into your purpose.
Come on.
And I want
come
to
on.
See. Men and women
come on.
Walking in your purpose.
Come on.
Your purpose.
Come on.
Not somebody else's.
That's right.
But yours.
That's
you
right.
have the power and the capacity to do this.
That's right.
Come on.
Come on.
Let's get this.
Let's Let's go. Oh man, I could be here all day. I can't believe the show went so quick. Like it went so quick. But you will catch us back here on Just Cool Radio next week, Thursday, 8 PM. Sharp. And if you've had a good time this evening with us, please tell a friend. Please share. Let people know. Don't keep it all to yourself.
Please.
Share. Sharing is caring. Share it. And you never know that what, you know, that person hears next week, that might set them off. That might resurrect the sleeping giant in them.
Yep.
Do you know what I mean? If they feel like they're dead, yeah, they could be resurrected by what they hear next week. Do you know what I mean? And this is not about us. This is about the giftings that God has given us to empower our community. You know what I mean? We want to empower our community. So, yeah, we're empowering. We're encouraging. And I hope we're entertaining as well. You know, I hope we're entertaining.
Well, as the weeks go on, you'll see more of our fabulous characters.
Oh, come on. Yeah. And more of the stuff that we see. We say, I mean, because Rue's got a few sayings.
I enjoy the house.
Oh. A few shades of
crazy.
A few shades of crazy. There's some things that are out there, you know, these days that are a few shades of crazy. Yeah. So, as I always say, it's a tough world out there. But even if it's a tough world, we can get through the tough world. You know what I mean? We can get through the tough world. But yeah, thank you so much. We want to say a big thank you to Anton.
Definitely.
For keeping us going. Yeah.
And thank you for everyone who's supporting us together and as individuals as well. Thank you to our friends and family, everyone that encouraged us and were cheering for us.
Yeah, everyone who's sharing.
Yeah.
Quickly, Marie, tell them about what happened when you was out the other day and then someone stopped you and said,
I was out doing
This is since Monday, by the way. This is since we put the promo up.
And I saw this lady. I went to tell the lady about our show. She's like, oh, I saw you on Jordan's. I'm like, yeah. It's me. So it was nice.
Yes.
So I'm just glad for the support.
That's right.
And I must say, that lovely lady messaged me today go for it.
Big
so
up
thank
Auntie
you
Kim.
So much.
Big
thank
up
you.
Auntie Kim. Yeah, 100%. 100%. Love you loads, Auntie Kim, if you're still listening with us. But yeah, that's it. That's a wrap. Next week, we're back. Yeah? God bless. Yeah, the mic's on. Marie, are you ready?
Hey, Jordan. Are you ready?
I'm ready. I don't know if they're ready, though.
Well, let's see.